Nice and comfy on here this morning on Studio 10. We are lifting the lid on how Hollywood works with director Bruce Beresford and producer Sue Milliken. But first, let's get a glimpse of just a few of the many movies that they've made.
In the early 70s, Bruce Beresford's first movies included The Adventures of Barry McKenzie.
G'day, ladies and gentlemen.
And the brilliant Don's Party.
Hello, Cap. Have a look at that. No crap.
Beautiful.
He hit his straps in the 80s with Breaking Morant. It won a string of awards, and he was nominated for an Oscar for Best Screenplay Adaption.
We caught them, and we shot them on the Rule 303.
He moved to Hollywood and grabbed another Oscar nomination for directing the wonderful Tender Mercies.
If you still need help the next couple of days, I'd like to work on.
His magnificent direction on Driving Miss Daisy didn't win him a personal award, but it scooped up four Oscars, including Best Picture for that year.
I don't need you, I don't want you, and I don't like you saying I'm rich.
In the 90s, along with producer Sue Milliken, he made acclaimed movies such as Black Robe and Paradise Road, featuring a very young Kate Blanchett. And the pair are still making great movies to this very day. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bruce Beresford and Sue Milliken.
Thank you so much for being on our squishy couch this morning.
I just wanted to get extra close to you.
Because we all wanted to talk to both of you, you see. None of us were going to say no, we were going to sit this interview out. Yeah.
So we might start with you. During the 90s, you and Bruce actually communicated via fax.
Yes.
Which I love that. It's so romantic. Such a quaint
notion. Well, that's because we weren't in the same place.
Of course. Yeah. Oh, remember that sound?
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, you've done it.
Oh, my God, I've actually found one.
You've actually got one.
But it actually meant that you were very honest in your communications about some of the frustrations when it came to Hollywood.
Well, it was the extension of letter writing, really, at that stage. I mean, emails are different. Emails now, you bash them out and you press send, and the other one comes back and you come and go. But with faxes, it was like you wrote them on your typewriter and you printed them out and then they went through the machine. So they were a lot more thought.
Now, Bruce, when you thought about Kate Blanchett for your film in Paradise Road, what happened? I think you met resistance, didn't you? Everyone agreed.
Well, we did from the studio, you see, because a lot of the money came from Fox, wasn't it? Fox. They really wanted a name actress in the role. Yeah. And I tested Kate and I said, you're not going to find a better actress. I said, I think an Australian actress should play the Australian nurse, and this young woman is fantastic.
And of course, that was one of the roles that catapulted her to one of the.
It was a key role in the film. But they wanted us to use a Minnie Driver.
And I said,
no, I don't want Minnie Driver. Kate Blanchett is going to do it. We both dug our heels in and got it.
I think it's worth saying that the film, we wanted to do the film because it was the story of the Australian nurses who were sunk, abandoned, and then imprisoned by the Japanese. And around that, around them was a cast of international people of British and Dutch. But the focus was the nurses, and that's why Kate's role was so important and why we had to fight and Bruce had to fight so hard for her.
She was wonderful in it. Mm. And Bruce, what in this collection of faxes between the two of you, what I really enjoyed reading about was the way that you talk about some of the Hollywood studios are insistent on casting particular big-name stars that actually don't necessarily make any sense with the project.
Yes, that's true. It's always been the case. But they've got a big investment. They want to protect it with name actors. Sometimes I wonder how anybody gets to be a name actor because the barriers seem to be so total.
How do you push back against that then?
You dig your heels in and say, I've got to have them. Sometimes they'll back off. Depends who you're dealing with.
And also how well you can convince them of other reasons why. Because they've got to sell the movie. They've got to get people to come and see it. They're putting the money in. So that's their only concern, really, is that the movie will make money.
Back to the Kate Blanchett thing, after the Hollywood saw how good she was and how successful that movie was, did they concede that you had a point and they were wrong?
No, you find that always in those cases they have no memory of what happened.
That's right. Now they just think it's right. Now they just think that they discovered Kate Blanchett.
Of course.
Right. You know, Bruce, one of my favourite films was Driving Miss Daisy. What was it like working with great stars and actors like Morgan Freeman and the Oscar-winning lady Jessica Tandy?
Well, it was one of the best experiences I've ever had because both of them were so incredibly professional and so charming. I mean, Jessica was actually 82 when we made the film. Yeah. We had to make her look younger for the first half of the film.
She was the oldest Oscar winner in history, wasn't
she?
She was.
But she was always, she was such a professional. She'd come on and I'd say, look, Jessica, you know, we've got to shoot this pretty quickly. I've got to do long takes with all the dialogue in one shot. Yeah. Not a problem, dear, she'd say.
Morgan Freeman, people have different accounts of what he's like. Well, is he a bit prickly at times?
We thought he was a very nice man. Yeah. I mean, he'd done that role when it was a play that was done off-Broadway. And I'd seen him do it in this little off-Broadway theatre. Mm. And I went backstage and met him. And he said, if you don't cast me in the film, I'm going to absolutely kill you. And so Richard Zanuck, who was the producer, and I both agreed he'd be perfect. But again, it was a big fight. Because Morgan had only done one role before that in a supporting role in a film.
Wow. Yes, this is the
other thing. So it was a struggle.
Yeah. No, I mean, Morgan Freeman now just feels like he's been around forever, but he's quite late that you actually, again, catapulted him into that stratospheric level.
He was 54. I remember one of the studio guys said to me, you really want to cast that old black man in that film? I don't believe it. And I said, that old black man is one of the best actors on the planet.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
That voice.
Yeah, beautiful voice. Oh, he's wonderful. Yeah.
He's a very charming man, very nice to work with.
Now, Sue, you guys, you're still working together after so many years.
Indeed.
So, obviously, you're a formidable team. What is it that you're working on at the moment?
Well, we've got a project that we've had really, and it's in the book we started working on it then, called The Women in Black, from a novel by Madeleine St. John.
Yes, yes.
About it's set in David Jones or in a department store in the 1950s, and it's about the impact of the first migrants. On Australian society, but it's Bruce will tell you a bit more about
You've said everything, so no, it is about that. It makes it sound a little serious. It's very lighthearted and it's very amusing. The book was a bestseller. And
is Kate Blanchett going to be in it?
I don't actually think there's a role for
Kate.
Every film, if you take a script to any distributor or sales agent, they say, can you get Kate Blanchett, please?
Yeah. I've had people say to me...
So you could work for a studio. Yes.
They'll say, if you get Kate Blanchett, we'll make the film. Yeah. Otherwise, we won't do it. And I say, is there any alternative?
Oh, you start.
I'm not sure if you know this, but our very own Jessica Rowe, she's had a turn as the... What did you play again? The Empress.
Empress.
In a pantomime.
And she's more than available if you want.
Oh, no, I mean, you've done some acting.
Yes, she has. I directed her. She was
Paradise Road 2.
Great. She was really good.
She'd be amazing. Now, if you want to read more about Sue and Bruce... this wonderful book that has been written by Sue and Bruce, it's called... There is a fax from Bruce. Yes. It is fascinating if you want to know about the inner workings of Hollywood. Thank you for both joining us here at Studio 10. Yeah. Thank you.